rower is the only piece of cardio equipment that you're going to find in most CrossFit gyms. The reason is it's fully functional. It sits with our tenets of high intensity, of functional movement, of core to extremity movement. It also follows a user-defined movement path, which makes it rare in that gym world of ellipticals and treadmills, which will set your resistance or set your speed. This rower doesn't do that. It responds to the inputs. The harder you go, the harder this machine makes you work. If you decide to go nice and soft, well, you know, it's going to go nice and soft with you. EC and I were given the opportunity to go up to Concept 2 last weekend, and we trained with Angela Hart, who is one of the de facto experts in indoor rowing in the world, and we learned a lot. We want to take some of that knowledge and share that with you, teach you how to use this machine and really make the most out of its capabilities. So we see, let's strap in. And before you get to using the rower, there are a couple things that you need to know about setting it up. The first is the foot stretcher here, the foot position. We're looking to have the ball of the foot right on this pad. We're looking to have good solid contact there. And with a lot of CrossFit folks, we tend to set those heel cups, that foot stretcher, too low. We don't want to do that. We want to get that ball of the foot right there. The second thing before you do anything else that you want to check is the damper setting. Now the damper is right here, and it adjusts 1 to 10. And this is drag factor. This basically controls how much air gets into the flywheel here. It is not resistance. Okay? Understand that the Concept 2 rower will make you work as hard as you work. Okay? The amount of resistance that you're going to get out of this machine is entirely dependent on how hard you pull, regardless of the damper setting. A damper setting of 10 is very much like rowing a rowboat. It's this big behemoth of a boat. If we get down to 1, we're talking about basically rowing air, you know, as if you could fly along the water. Most folks are going to find that their sweet spot on the Concept 2 is at a damper setting between 5 and 3. And this most closely mimics a racing skull, which is what this machine is designed to train folks for. Once we've had our damper setting and we've got our feet set, we start in with the mechanics of the rowing stroke. I recommend that you take this performance monitor and just get it out of the way. As you're learning technique, we don't want a bunch of numbers, buttons, and whistles confusing you. And we'll get back to that, but we don't need it right now. So Eva Claire's got that adjusted for her feet, and we're going to start in the catch position. This is basically the start. So we'll notice a couple things, okay? Just like our clean, just like our sumo deadlift high pull, just like our deadlift, her back is tight. She's in extension. So we've got the chest up, and we've got that lower back arched. Her arms are long, okay? Just like if you bend early on an Olympic pull, you're not going to get any power to the bar. She's not going to get any power to this handle if she has bent arms, okay? So we've got that good start position. The other thing to pay attention to is the position of the knee relative to the ankle. And we essentially want a 90 degree angle here, or just under, where the knee is stacked over the heel. Now I don't mean in a vertical direction. We're looking here. So this will be your heel, this will be your knee, your femur. We've still got that 90 degree angle. Now to start the drive, it's going to be only leg. Just like our deadlift, just like our clean, she's not going to pull early with the arms, she's not going to extend the back, she's merely going to drive her legs. So EC, show us leg drive. Boom. And what do you notice there? You notice that the leg drives, but this is all one rigid unit. The hip and shoulder move back together. And only when she's completed this leg drive does she extend her back. So go ahead back into that start position called the catch. We're in the catch, and she drives hard with her legs. Boom. And only when she's done that does that back go, do we get that back extension. Good. So now let's link that together. Show me that leg drive and back extension. Boom. Notice that she still has not bent her arms, all right? We're still getting all that power from the hip and the erectors of the back directly to that handle. And now let's finish off that pull. The finish, she's going to pull her hands in. Now the handle is going to come to her sternum. okay? We're not sending it way up here under the chin. It's going right to the sternum. So let's send that handle back in, get in that catch position for me, EC. Let's show them the whole thing, okay? All the way back and pull. Good, so we'll notice leg drive, back arms. Leg, back arms. Leg, back arms, right? There's no disruption of the kinetic chain there. This is a core to extremity movement. The hip goes, and all that power from the hip is making it to the handle. We know that if she bends her arm early, it's not gonna get there. If she extends her back early, it's not gonna get there. So there are a bunch of faults that we can see, but you're gonna find some real commonalities between the faults on the rower and the faults in a deadlift and a sumo deadlift high pull. Okay? If we see the butt going early, if we see the shoulders going early, yeah, let's show them that again. Send that butt. Right? It's obvious we're not getting power to that rower. Do it one more time. That's the butt going early. Okay? How about an early arm bend, EC? Now on the surface, it might look all right, but to the educated eye, we're seeing that she's getting a severely diminished power output. And once we get that performance monitor back up and we can throw an eye on it, the numbers aren't gonna lie. They're gonna show that as well.